Hello subscriber, my dear students, hope you are doing good in this pandemic. I have created this channel to discuss the various topics of commerce in a very precise way. Hope you learn from it. Let's start.
Hello dear students and my dear subscriber, today my topic of discussion is service decision making process. Before going to this topic, let us understand that service performance, especially those that contain few tangible clues, can be difficult to evaluate. As a result, there is a great risk of making a purchase that proved to be disappointing. Customers who have purchased a physical good that subsequently proves to be a poor choice can often easily recoverable from their mistakes. For instance, they can return a defective CD player, exchange a clothing that is wrong size, or have a car repaired under warranty. These options are not readily available with services, although recovery is easier for some type of services than others. In case of possession, processing services, repeating the performance may be acceptable option. For example, cleaning service can be recleaned at an office if customer complains about the poor quality of the job. By contrast, people processing services that are performed on people's bodies may be hard to be reversed. After all, a bad haircut must be grown out, and consequently a faulty surgical operation or a poor tattoo may be done, which may last longer. If we go by the categories of service decision making process, first we have information search. Consumer obtain information about product and services for personal sources, that is friends or expert, and non-personal sources, that may be mass media or selective media. When purchasing goods, consumer make generous use of both personal as well as non-personal sources, because both effectively convey information about qualities. When purchasing services, on the other hand, consumer seeks to rely on great extent of personal sources. It is also found that perceived risk, while some degree of perceived risk probably accompanies all purchase transaction, more risks would appear to involve in the purchase of services than purchase of goods, because services are intangible, non-standardized, and sold without guarantees. Clear? So the second one, we have evaluation of alternatives. In evaluation of alternatives, is evoke set of alternative that group products a consumer considers acceptable option in a given product category, which is likely to be smaller with services than goods. One reason involved in differences with retailing of goods and services, that is, to purchase goods, consumer generally shop in retail store that display competing products in close proximity, then clearly demonstrating the possible alternatives. In the other hand, in purchase services, consumer visit an establishment. Establishment example, the bank, dry cleaner, hair salon, okay, that almost offer what they offer? They offer only a single brand for sale. Again, another reason is that consumer are unlikely to find more than one or two businesses providing the same services in a given geographical area, whereas they may find numerous retail stores carrying identical manufacturing products. And finally, the third reason for a smaller evoke set is the difficulty in obtaining adequate pre-purchase information about the services. Okay, the another category is service purchase and consumption. Here, the business houses has been compared with compared service provision with a drama, observing that both aim to create and maintain desirable impression before the audience, and both recognize the way to accomplish this, okay, by carefully imagining the actors and physically setting as their behavior. In fact, the service marketeer plays the role of drama, including director, choreographer, writers, yes, to ensure that the performance of the actors are pleasing to the audience. Now, the skill of the service actor in performing their routines would appear, and their commitment to the show is about quality service delivery. While service actors are present in most of the service performance, and their importance increase when the direct personal contact increases, such as hospital, resort, restaurant, yes, and when the service involve repeat contact, and when the contact personnel act as the actor have discretion in determining the nature of service and how it is being delivered. Okay, and the concept says that service marketer provides the performance, and they are always committed to the service delivery, and service provider, and finally service employees need to perform their roles according to the expectation of the customer. Okay, in a layman point of view, script consists of a set of ordered actions, actors and object that through repeated involvement define what customer expects from a service purchase and consumption. So the next factor is post-purchase evaluation. Under post-purchase evaluation, we have attribution of dissatisfaction. Here actually what happened is that when consumer are disappointed with purchase because the product did not fill their intended needs or did not perform satisfactorily or were not worth their prices, they may attribute their dissatisfaction to a number of sources or different sources among the producer, retailer or themselves. Because consumer participate to a great extent in definition and production of services, they may feel more responsible for their dissatisfaction when they purchase goods. Okay, consumer participate in great extent in the definition of product and service. As we know, they may feel more responsible for their dissatisfaction when they purchase services than purchasing of goods. And an example is consider a female consumer purchasing a haircut, receiving the haircut. The desire depend upon her specification, clear specification, and which the stylist need to act. If she get disappointed, she may blame the stylist for her lack of skills or herself for choosing why wrong stylist or not communicating her, okay, regarding the haircut clearly. So under post-purchase evaluation, we have innovation diffusion. The rate of diffusion of an innovative product depends on consumer perception of the innovation with regard to five characteristics. Those are relative advantage, compatibility, communicability, divisibility and complexity. Okay, an offering that has relative advantage over existing or competing products, that is compatible with existing norms. Then we have values and behavior, that is communicable. And divisible, that can be tried or tested on limited basis, diffuses more quickly than others. An offering that is complex, that is difficult to understand or use, diffuses more slowly than others. So another one we have, the brand loyalty. It is a degree to which consumers are committed to a particular brand of goods or services depend on a number of factors. These factors are cost of changing brands, that means switching the cost, availability of substitute, perceived risk associated with the purchase, and the degree to which they have obtained the satisfaction. Because it may be costly to change brand of services, because they may have more difficulty being aware of the availability of substitutes, and also because of higher risk may accompany the services. Consumer may likely to remain customer of particular companies with services than with goods. Greater such cost and monetary cost may be involved in changing brand of services than changing brand of goods. Because of the difficulty of obtaining information about services, consumer may be unaware of the alternatives or substitute for their brands, which may be uncertain about the availability of alternatives to increase satisfaction over the present brands. So we discuss you about today the service marketing process and the various factors. Thank you for watching my video. Kindly subscribe my channel, and in this pandemic I request to be safe.